CBS Sports college basketball coverage is sponsored by K Jewelers, the number one jewelry store in America. Every kiss begins with K. DirecTV, if you call yourself a sports fan, you gotta get DirecTV. And by Ram Trucks, guts, glory, Ram. Baylor in Kentucky coming up here on CBS, our season premiere. There is Scott Drew. What a job he's done turning this Baylor program into such a national power. Twice, just a game away from taking them to the Final Four. And here's his lineup. Again, Pierre Jackson is their star, the Big 12 preseason player of the year with Walton. Heslip's back after missing a game. And Jefferson, and look out for Isaiah Austin, 7-1 freshman from Arlington, Texas. The Kentucky Wildcats, all new starters after the championship team a season ago. Archie Goodwin with Julius Mays, who's actually a senior, played at Wright State and North Carolina State. This is his third school. Poitras, Noel, and Wiltshire underneath for Coach Cal, who brought Kentucky its first national title in 14 years when they won down in New Orleans. He's never lost a game at home, Clark, here at Kentucky.
That's right.
And our officials today, Antonio Petty, Pat Adams, Doug Sermons. These two again met down in Atlanta in a regional final just 8 months back, and here they meet again. And the tip belongs to Baylor at 4-2 on the season. They haven't played in 8 days.
Yeah, lost last week to Charleston and the College of Charleston, and Brady Heslip right out of the gate gets a high quality look for one of the elite three-point shooters in the country. Kentucky wants to make sure they tag Heslip. They can't give him those kind of looks throughout the game.
In his last game, Heslip made 8 from 3. He missed that last game against College of Charleston. Big absence for them. First game he's ever missed at Baylor because he had his appendix removed. Now here comes Kentucky, also 4-2 on the season, and also coming in off a loss just a little more than 36 hours ago at Notre Dame.
Zone defense here by Baylor, and an errant pass that time by Nerlens Noel. He's a terrific passer for a big guy, and that's where you want to attack the zone, in the middle, in that foul line area. You just have to execute the pass a little better than that.
Now this man handling the ball right here, Pierre Jackson, you featured him in our opening. He's probably the most experienced, best leader we'll see on the floor today. He whips it inside to the freshman Austin, who takes the shot in the paint and gets the generous roll for the game's first two.
Jim, I love the patience there displayed by the freshman. Up and under move, good footwork, good finish.
This is Goodwin, who's had some big performances already here through the first 6 games. Whipping it inside, Noel gets the basket to go, and the foul. The National High School Player of the Year scoring Kentucky's first basket.
Beautifully executed here. The ball went side to side, and the soft spot in the zone, folks, is the middle area. And when you get that ball reversed or swung, you have a chance to attack right into the middle of that zone, and a good catch and finish by Noel.
Foul on Corey Jefferson and Noel with the three-point play. The USA Today Player of the Year and out of Everett, Massachusetts. This is Walton over to Jefferson as it's stolen. And this is Goodwin taking it in for the dunk. Archie Goodwin, freshman from Little Rock, Arkansas, with the steal and the dunk. Jackson right back, wasting no time to answer.
I love that. Pierre Jackson going the length of the court, not sticking his head down after the score by Goodwin, and attacked and got an easy one.
On the baseline, Poitras whips it back outside. Mays, he's been hitting these lately. Back of the rim that time, and a reach in and a tap away back to Kentucky. Mays takes it, and he's rejected by Jefferson. Goodwin, and he too is blocked. Back-to-back blocks by Jefferson, and out with it is Kentucky again. Wild action. It is timeout called by Kentucky on the floor. How about that man's scramble?
We love it.
Here's the home win streak, 55 and counting. The first win actually didn't take place at Rupp. It took place at the old Memorial Auditorium. And now 54 straight at Rupp.
And a furious pace to start this game, Jim. Not to be unexpected, both of these teams average 79 points a game and enjoy playing full throttle basketball.
Noel DeWiltshire, he launches a no-go and Walton comes out with it.
Well, you talked about experience. A.J. Walton has started half the games in his career. He's a senior and one of the leaders along with Pierre Jackson for Baylor.
Here he is, Clark, missing on the three, only Noel underneath. Mays skips it over to the far side to Poitras, who lost the handle into the arms of Walton. Up ahead for Jackson and misses from the other side.
Lost his concentration.
But he got the steal. Reached in and took it away from Goodwin. Jackson, he'll take the three. Walton tap, nope, comes back out to Kentucky.
Both of these teams love to operate in the open court, Jim. And we're seeing a full display of that here in the first 3 minutes.
Poitras, he hits the three. Alex Poitras, freshman from Clarksville, Tennessee.
Well, you talk about Poitras. He's got a major body on him, really strong and skilled in every aspect of the game. The one thing that they'd like to see him do is just be more assertive and aggressive in his demeanor, because he's got all the physical tools.
Really a late developer to the game, too. Here's the alley-oop. And too high for Jefferson, chased down by Noel. 8-2 stretch here by Kentucky. And right back to Poitras. He was on the end line. It's going back to Baylor.
Here he is catching a nice pass from Mays, and Baylor late getting out to him. But he's got the ability to knock down the three, but also can do major work inside, and going to get a break now because he's gassed. That four-minute segment was full throttle both ways. And now we'll get a chance to see a little more relaxed pace as Baylor going to operate against the half-court defense of Kentucky, man-to-man here.
Yeah, Kentucky's turned it over four times. Gathers just coming into the game, and he banks it home. Rico Gathers, freshman from Louisiana. Good one, has the open jumper. Pushing it ahead again. Baylor to the other end with Walton. Step up, takes two. Almost tapped in accidentally by Goodwin, and it's off Baylor. It'll be Kentucky basketball out of the break. Back here with Kentucky up by a basket. Coach Cal wanted to see more energy. We certainly have had that. There was a lot of energy down in Atlanta. In the Elite Eight matchup between these two, there's Kid Gilchrist, who led the team with 19 points. Anthony Davis had 18 and 11 plus six blocks. Kentucky actually raced out to a 20-point halftime lead, went on the win 82 to 70 on its way to taking the title. And for Baylor, that was the second time in 3 years the Bears lost in a regional final to the eventual national champion, Duke in 2010, and again, Kentucky last season.
You and I were bred there for both of those
games.
That's
right.
Yeah, we actually called both of those games a loss against Duke and then last year against Kentucky. Unlike this year, that Kentucky team last year was the consensus favorite pretty much from the start of the season. We don't have that same landscape this year, and as a result, a more wide open road to the Final Four. Both of these teams off to a terrific start in terms of pace and typically take good care of the ball, and that's one of his strengths. Kyle Wiltshire is a terrific three-point shooter.
Wiltshire can really fire it, and he knocks down the three. And Heslip shut off from firing up a three of his own. Bounced in, Gathers, stolen away by Noel. Ryan Harrow's on the floor for Kentucky. And Goodwin driving in, draws the foul on Heslip.
Jim, he is so good in the open court because he has excellent ball handling skills. He's long and rangy, and he really has a knack for sliding to the basket off the dribble in transition.
Already's had a 28-point game against Morehead State. Got a Sports fan on your gift list. CBSSports.com shop has officially licensed NFL gear and NCAA gear from over 500 schools and three-day shipping on every order. Shop.CBSSports.com. Second one goes for Goodwin, who also came very close to a triple-double in the game against Long Island. 22 points, 9 rebounds, 9 assists. So Goodwin ups the lead here to 6. And Baylor's had some sloppy possessions, and it's Harrow coming out with it. That's 5 turnovers on the Bears. Harrow off the glass, no. Tapped up and in, no. Noel trying to do that.
Well, Kentucky doing a good job defensively, Jim. Not only in handling Pierre Jackson in the pick and roll, but being active with their hands. You don't necessarily always have to get a deflection, but when your hands are engaged, you tend to put pressure on the offensive players.
Baylor with Deuce Bello on the floor, number 14. Jackson with a tough three, back of the rim. Bello was chasing after it. Wiltshire, though, touched it last. Stays with the Bears, and they'll bring back Austin. And Jefferson will get a rest.
Kentucky's half-court defense, Jim, really not allowing Baylor to get much activity inside. They forced the Bears to pretty much settle for perimeter shots in the half court. For Baylor to have a chance to get some momentum and rhythm going offensively, they need to get that ball inside some, either off the dribble or on the post up.
That's Heslop. Fighting for it inside. Gathers, who's been working hard since coming in.
Kentucky. Big time board there.
That foul is on Noel, his first. Kentucky's also brought in a big presence. Willie Cauley-Stein, a 7-footer from Kansas. Gathers.
Oh, oh, oh. Plexiglass flying everywhere.
I saw you take cover.
Yes, I did. Soften it up, big fella. Soften it up a touch. Get a little air under it.
That better. Do better? There you go.
Better. Boy, you like the work he does on the glass, though, Jim. He's averaging a rebound every 4 minutes that he plays, which is a terrific ratio in the college game based on number of possessions teams typically get.
That was Harrow missing on the jumper and a whistle on Baylor inside. And it's called on Bello. And that's team foul number 3. So Scott Drew, he also had to replace some prominent players off of last year's Final Eight team. Noel goes baseline. Poitras rattles it home. It's a Baylor team that lost Perry Jones III, Quincy Miller, and Quincy Acey, who was such a presence and part of the winningest class in Baylor history. Oh, that was just a throwaway by Bello and a foul near midcourt on Jackson. And they're calling it an intentional.
No play on the ball. Clearly the right call. A blatant intentional foul. Scott Drew wondering why. But take a look. It's easy to see why. That's a grab. And that's definitely the letter and the spirit of the rule.
So first foul on Jackson. And good one. We'll shoot another here. And of course, Kentucky will have possession. Mr. Basketball from the state of Arkansas. Again, 1-2 at the line.
You know, Kentucky has really disrupted things defensively. They've not allowed Baylor to get any real high-quality inside looks, and they've done a good job on the glass. But I expected Kentucky, Jim, on the heels of that loss at Notre Dame, to come out with a little more vigor, particularly in the defensive area.
Oh, the Commonwealth's been up in arms after that performance up at Notre Dame. They were saying, where was the energy? Where was the passion?
Well, the Commonwealth is always up in arms about this basketball.
It doesn't
team.
Take much.
It sure doesn't.
Noel follows it up. No. And Coley Stein tried as well to get the put back.
Jim, I love the activity of Kentucky at both ends. Baylor needs to settle down and try to get Corey Jefferson something inside.
Austin, he could shoot it outside and instead gives it up on the floor. Jefferson battling with Poitras. Again, Coach Cal's team was defeated at South Bend a little more than 36 hours ago by 14. Second largest loss he's had as the Kentucky coach. He's only lost 16 times overall in his 4 years. And he just felt like, you know, there wasn't that competitive spirit, that will to win. And all day Friday, everywhere you go, people walk up to you. They walk up to us. What's wrong with this team?
Well, John Calipari, as you take a look at the choreographed pass on the alley-oop, Baylor sniffed it out easily. Good push ahead here by Jackson. Well done, but you talk about the concern some folks had with the Kentucky team. John Calipari basically was talking about fostering an effort of competitive spirit. And with young players, sometimes they don't realize how hard they have to play for every possession, every second of every possession, particularly when you play your first legitimate road game.
The foul was on Mays. Walton at the line. It was a beautiful pass in there. Bounce pass by Pierre Jackson. Thursday on CBS, Sherlock Holmes is back. No mystery why Elementary is a hit. Catch a new episode Thursday, only CBS on America's most watched network. Walton, the senior, gets them both.
A little token full court pressure here by Baylor, Jim. Just trying to disrupt the rhythm of Kentucky. You make them utilize some of the shot clock, and then they sit back here in the zone. See how soft that middle area is? Look how wide open it is, right where the SEC is. That's where you want to attack.
Cutting in the lane, trying to get it to Noel. Again, ball on the floor. And a tie up. The arrow's going to Baylor. Got the under 12 break here. Baylor has not made a shot from the floor in the last 4 minutes. In September, the Baylor basketball team went through a little boot camp with the 4th Sustainment Brigade down at Fort Hood Army Base, Fort Hood, Texas. Team went through a leadership reaction course. See Pierre Jackson bears an interesting twist on how to get prepared for a season.
No question about it. There are a lot of different ways to get guys not only physically prepared for the grinds of a long college basketball season, but mentally and emotionally prepared. You know, I know a number of teams that actually go through that type of training. And, you know, you look at Scott Drew now in his 10th season at Baylor, and you look at what John Calipari has done here at Kentucky. I mean, they're two of the more remarkable coaching turnarounds and levels of success. I mean, Scott Drew's teams won 21 games his first 3 seasons. They basically were the Phoenix coming from the ashes when he took over there, and he's done it at a high level. John Calipari obviously has been nothing short of spectacular here in developing his teams at Kentucky and typically developing new teams each season because of the early exodus of a number of his players to the NBA.
This is Austin. 2 7-footers battling right here, and it's swatted away by Coley Stein as Baylor's missed his last 5 shots, and again more than 4 minutes without a make. Wiltshire, no, and it comes back out to Kentucky.
Pierre Jackson came up gimpy there as he tried to get to that rebound, Jim. You can see him noticeably limping out there on the perimeter. And
oh, and they're going to address that right now, which will summon to the table to check in a freshman from Houston, LJ Rose. Heslip also coming back out on the floor.
Well, this could be a significant major loss for Baylor if Pierre Jackson is not able to return. He's so critically important to everything Baylor tries to do.
Bobby Stein. Short off the glass, Poitras. And that draws a whistle on Baylor. 5 offensive rebounds by Kentucky in this game, and this last one could be costly to Baylor.
Hard to tell what happened. Poitras came in over the top, but it looked like he came down awkwardly, and they have done something to his quadricep, it seems. Boy, the activity of Kentucky has been very impressive, Jim. Ball movement's been much better. One of the things they didn't do at Notre Dame and South Bend was trust each other and share the ball. Doing a better job of that here early today.
This is Rose, who comes in for Jackson. Over to Austin, and Holly Stein got a hand on it. Back out high, no new shot clock.
How about that effort by a seven-footer, Jim, to go down and almost come up with the steal getting on the floor for that ball.
Lob, and it got away from him. He's trying to hit a slashing Jefferson. From the corner, Mays rattles out. Fouled up by Coley Stein, comes soaring through. And Kentucky's up by eight. Timeout, Baylor. Off the Mays miss, look at this. Coley Stein, hustle at each end.
Kentucky very active and energetic here today. Coley Stein initiates this break. And here he is right here. That ball's going to get there. And then the missed shot. And here he comes right to the rim. Nobody puts a body on him. That's a terrific play by the seven-footer. We come at you from another angle. Right through the rim. You know, I talked to him yesterday at practice, Jim. He played high school football and was a fantastic receiver, but he said his best sport and his favorite sport early on was baseball. He's just a terrific athlete at 7 feet tall.
Yeah, how about a 7 foot wide receiver? He was a tremendous football player.
He actually told me yesterday that he misses it a little bit.
And you see Pierre Jackson's back in the game. Long lob, wow. And right on it is Jefferson for the dunk.
Wow, that's the first opportunity. Clean opportunity inside. Baylor has gotten, what a pass.
Breaks a 5 minute, 10 second field goal drought. Olson in the game now for the Cats as Wilcher helps lead the perimeter passing. Here's Wilcher.
Well, that is really terrific ball movement and getting a high quality shooter an open look. You can't do it much better than that if you're Kentucky.
Austin with a three, and the freshman unable to hit it. Wilcher saves it over to Goodwin. Baylor has not made a three in this game on six attempts.
They've had a couple of good looks at it. I know Heslop had a couple of good looks, and Austin is capable from out there, and that was a wide open shot he just missed.
Goodwin in traffic, lost it. Walton takes middle, takes it to the hole for two. And that'll draw a timeout by Coach Cal. He's furious with that. We're going to talk to his team about how you don't allow that. Quick timeout called by Coach Calipari as Baylor beat Kentucky back down the floor.
And you don't want to give a team that's struggling an easy basket. The alley-oop play from Jackson to Corey Jefferson was a high-risk, high-reward play, but the layup in transition by Walton is one that's inexcusable if you're Kentucky. You've got to stop the ball, and that's why Calipari called the timeout.
Reaching in and making the steal is Jackson up ahead. Heslop. And he'll be shooting free throws. He had two Kentucky players there to defend it, but Coley Stein is whistled for the contact.
Good active hands against the zone. You put that ball, it actually didn't get on the floor. Jackson was there before Coley Stein could get it on the ground. And then a nice job by Heslop to use the rim, run the floor, use the rim, and expect contact and get himself to the foul line.
And again, Heslop at the line, missed his first ever game at Baylor and their last one. Tuesday on CBS is the Victoria's Secret Fashion Show with superstar performances by Rihanna, Justin Bieber, Bruno Mars. Don't miss the hottest show on TV has to offer Tuesday on CBS. Heslip.
You know, Jim, it's funny. These are two teams that we saw a year ago, but they're very different from the personnel that we saw last season, and very similar at this juncture of this season in that they're trying to figure out who they are, looking to establish identity, new players and new positions and new roles. And as you said earlier, I think both of these teams will have a chance as they get better to make a deep run in postseason play.
Well, these five on the floor right now from Kentucky were not participants on last year's championship team as Noel misses the dunk. Four of the five on the floor at the moment for Baylor, however, were on that Elite Eight team. Only the freshman Austin on the floor right now. A newcomer.
But in terms of how much they played, obviously, yep. Walton played decent minutes and Corey Jefferson didn't play much at all.
Here's Austin after getting the handle. Off the floor with it is Goodwin. Lobbing it to Colby Stein. You can see that one coming. Walton bounces it over. Jefferson, you talked about he didn't play all that much. He has really stepped up this year, talking about Corey Jefferson averaging 14 points and 9 rebounds in the early season.
Well, taking advantage of the opportunity, Jim. You know, he's a redshirt junior, so he's got some maturity to him, and he's worked against those three guys we talked about them not having this year. Perry Ellis, both Quincy's, AC and Miller in practice. So he's ready to step into a prominent role and off to a great start this season.
Here's a Kentucky alley-oop, but it's an 8-2 stretch for the Baylor Bears, who were down 8 and now are down only 2. Jim Nance, Clark Kellogg back here at Rupp Arena. Both teams more turnovers committed than baskets made so far in this one.
Yeah, fast pace, active hands both ways. We're going to take a look at some of those cough-ups. Here you see good hustle by Goodwin. Able to come up with the ball there, anticipating, getting into the passing lane. Active hands. And then in the zone defense, Baylor able to force a few turnovers. Both of these teams come in, Jim, only averaging about 12 turnovers a game, so they're well above the normal pace, but some of that has to do with being young teams that are playing a little faster than normal and then just not making plays. And the activity defensively, particularly Kentucky and its man-to-man.
It'll be Baylor basketball. Nice little stretch here for the Bears. After being down by 8. And away from the ball, they're going to call an illegal screen on Gathers of Baylor.
Yeah, I think he was trying to get a little too much of the defender there. You've got to allow your offensive player, you get stationary and anchor your feet in good screening position. Then the guy who's using the screen has to run his defender into him. Gathers that time tried to help his teammate too much.
And again, Baylor showing signs that might want to apply a little backcourt pressure here.
Mm-hmm, just some token pressure. Again, Kentucky trying to grow Archie Goodwin into the point guard position. So Baylor thinking maybe they can fluster the first year backcourt player into a mistake or two.
That's Goodwin with a 2.
Oh, great work by Nerlens Noel.
And Gathers got a piece of him.
And if Gathers gets a piece of you, you'll feel it.
You know it.
Yes, sir. He's well put together.
No, he's actually a second cousin of the late Hank Gathers. Mm-hmm.
Doing a nice job in his first campaign with Baylor.
Hank Gathers, the fallen former star at Loyola Marymount.
Mm-hmm.
20 years back. And the front end of the one-on-one miss, but the arrow and the tie will bring it back to Kentucky again.
Well, you think about that LMU team, what a run they had 20-plus years ago.
Yep, they got to the final 8 also.
Yep, exactly. Tragic. Tragic passing of Hank Gathers, who was not only a terrific player, but a guy that many admired and respected for what he was as a young man and who he was.
Polson, number five on the floor. Here he is for Kentucky.
Nice.
Noel feeds it outside Wiltshire. Got the shot they wanted. And again, gathered so strong underneath.
I think Wiltshire is guiding his shot just a tad the last two attempts, Jim. Sometimes when you're a really good shooter, if it doesn't go in the bottom of the hole, you start to get a little tentative with it.
Walton, some nifty ball handling there, but this is the short shot. Poitras lost it for a moment. And it's back to Baylor, a ninth turnover committed by Kentucky.
And that was a careless one there. Pass was a little off target, but Poitras did not look it into his hands. And you know, if you're Baylor, after the sloppy start, not able to get anything going, to put together a little mini surge to be within two on the road, with 5 minutes to go, you've got to feel pretty good. Let's see what they can execute here in the half court.
Yeah, they haven't hit a three yet. And like I said, rough start, but chance to tie it right there off the glass. Up ahead, Wildcats get it to Mays. They'll wait for help, but then throws it right into the arms of a Baylor defender. Last touch by the Bears.
Well, this Baylor team is a really good three-point shooting team. That's a high-quality look for a guy who shot 45% from the three-point line last year.
Noel, and that's going to be offensive. Nerlens Noel, his second. You know, when this Kentucky season started, after you lost the bumper crop of Kid Gilchrist and, of course, Anthony Davis, there was so much talk about Nerlens Noel being the high school player of the year, and everybody wanted to see what he looked like in a Kentucky uniform. What have you seen?
Oh, I like what I see. He's similar to Anthony Davis in his defensive presence. I mean, he is a terrific shot blocker, has great instincts for shot blocking. He's long, he's athletic, he's got an excellent motor. Not quite as polished offensively as Davis was a year ago, as there's a three-pointer for Pierre Jackson and the Baylor Bears. They shoot 35% from behind the arc, so they're a pretty good three-point shooting team. And with that, they take the lead. But getting back to Noel, I like his energy and presence defensively, and he's improving as an offensive player. So he's got a really bright future ahead of himself.
That is Poitras, who not gathers to the floor, but they don't get the call this time. So Kentucky takes the lead back by one. Gathers, wild shot.
Sure was.
Pauly Stein with the box out. Getting baseline, Poitras. Tried to force a dunk. Jackson from the wing of three and can't get two in a row to go.
Wasn't quite gathered. Was unsettled. Was sloppy handling the ball there, and that led to a sloppy shot. I like the shot in the open court, but he wasn't really shot ready there.
Mays from the wing, and that's a three. He's been hitting him the last couple of games. Had seven over the course of the last two. Transfer, actually, from North Carolina State to Wright State, where he graduated. He's now a graduate student at Kentucky, as Austin gets the foul call against Pauly Stein and the basket to drop. And we got a break in the action. Second foul on Pauly Stein. We'll hear from Coach Drew when we come back. We're back here at Rupp Arena, and Coach Drew, thanks for taking a moment here. How about your thoughts on the early action?
Well, I thought it looked like Clark Kellogg on that last layup by Isaiah, so that's a good thing. So got to keep him out of transition, got to do a better job on the glass, and then got to know where those shooters are. They got two of them out there that we can't give open looks to.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you, guys.
How about that? Isaiah Austin getting a little Clark Kellogg comparison. And he'll be shooting a free throw coming up after making the basket, drawing the foul on Pauly Stein.
Well, I had a few and ones in my day.
I know you did.
Yes, sir. You got to slide in there. Concentrate on finishing, but expect contact and play through it. And the freshman did all of that on that last layup.
He had a few more LBs, too, than Isaiah.
Did. Yeah.
When this kid fills out, he is some special-looking talent of his own.
He really is. He is what we would call gracile. I want to throw a new word at you, partner. Gracile. G-R-A-C-I-L-E. We got a couple of guys out there that are gracile. Cauley Stein.
Okay.
Nerlens Noel. So from that description, I'm going to have you tell me what gracile is. Think about it for a little bit.
Okay, here's Harrell with the three.
I didn't mean to stump
you. Obviously, it's a little morphing of a couple of neat terms here. Goodwin almost. Yes, he does come away with it. Has Goodwin. Lumps it. And that's gracile right there. Cauley Stein. I'm thinking green as grass.
Slender of build.
Okay.
Is the operative word. Slender of build. Agile. And in a basketball way, productive.
Okay.
All right.
So how did you come to gracile with all of that?
It's a real word. I mean, it's a legitimate word. Yeah, it's not a compound word that I made up.
I thought you made
one. No,
no. Because you know how you have your little, usually food ties.
Yep. I do have food analogies at work at times.
That's what I thought you were going. All right. Foul on Wiltshire. Which is his first. Oh. Jefferson missing the dunk, but will head to the line. So a second quick win on Wiltshire.
I tell you what, both teams have been a little sloppy, but some of that is due to the defense and the activity both ways. But the energy and the aggressiveness, the tenacity, I think, is there both ways. I mean, both of these teams coming off losses are playing with that kind of bad taste in their mouth feeling.
Coming up, AT&T at the half. Tim Brando and company are down in Atlanta previewing today's SEC championship matchup. Number 2, Alabama. Number 3, Georgia. Clark and I will discuss the upcoming men's basketball season all the way to the wire. Coming up on AT&T at the half. Baylor has never defeated Kentucky in history, 0-7. In fact, four times, which has been a long time, but four times Kentucky hosted Baylor. Baylor never within 34 or closer than 34 when playing here in Lexington. Well, this is a program right now that is a national power under Coach Drew. And Kentucky goes inside. There's Jefferson with the block after hitting the free throws at the other end.
Yeah, Jefferson averaging a couple of block shots a game, so you can't expect to get easy ones off there.
Oh, and Heslip hits the three. And that puts Baylor back up by one. They face some of the worst criminals of all time, but Monday they'll take on a real stunner. A Victoria's Secret model on an all-new Hawaii 5-0 Monday on America's number one network. So coming out of a Kentucky timeout after a Hislip three gives Baylor the 27-26 advantage. And Poitras calling for a little help. Goodwin comes back for it. Mays just hit one, but can't hit this three. Up ahead, Walton uses the body to shield off Mays and get the lay-in at the two-minute mark.
Mays had a better option. He could have given it to Hood in the corner. He took a challenge three, and when it missed, that long rebound led to the runout. See, Mays had an extra pass to the left, did not make it. That long miss leads to an immediate runout and a good look ahead by Heslip to Walton.
Isaiah Austin coming back in after a brief break. A third foul on Gathers of Baylor. We'll put Goodwin at the line for the 1-1. And you mentioned John Hood, he's on the floor for the first time for Kentucky. Number four, a junior from Madisonville, Kentucky.
Actually just left as you were.
Just as we said that.
Yeah.
Brought him back to the bench. Paulson on the floor now for Kentucky. Another homegrown Wildcat talent by way of Nicholasville. Two free throws by Goodwin. Trims the lead to one. Long lob again, and that was a good pass.
It was. He just couldn't squeeze it, Jim.
Jefferson couldn't handle it.
And he was open, too. And what a look by Pierre Jackson.
From midcourt.
That's not easy to do. That's a real skill to be able to throw that pass accurately. Already 21 turnovers between the teams again. On the season, they average 24 between them, so well above that. Good look inside to the middle and a nice take by Poulter.
Oh, tapped up once. Thomas Stein, no. And Austin with a reach in, going to be called against Kentucky's Jared Paulson.
I tell you what, around the rim at both ends, because there's such activity and size and athleticism, you've got to go strong. You can't try to finesse baskets in against either one of these teams. Cauley Stein guilty of the foul there. But the athleticism and activity in the paint area, you better bring it through bodies and go with force.
Yeah, it looked like it might be on Paulson. It's on Cauley Stein instead. And he has three as Austin's at the line. One and one. Tapped around to Kentucky. Noah, real sloppy turnover right there. That one leaves you shaking your head.
Yeah, it does. SMH. You know that language, right? Shaking my head. SMH.
Yeah, always.
Yeah.
Partner, it's been a while since New Orleans. I'm still adjusting. Okay.
We'll get you up to speed.
I need my glossary of terms. That slip. Follow up that time by Jefferson.
And Jim, you talked about his improvement. This young man has really stepped into his expanded opportunity and role because he's prepared while waiting. He hasn't been lazy in waiting for his opportunity. He's been going after it, and you're seeing the results of that work here on the big stage.
Yeah, the junior from Killeen, Texas, as we move inside the minute to go. Good one. Knew he was going to be fouled, so he just lobbed it in the direction of the cylinder.
How do you shoot 71% from the floor and rank fourth in the country? Corey Jefferson does it just like that. Staying close to the rim and pursuing missed shots. Well done by number 34 there.
Second foul, though, on Pierre Jackson will send Goodwin to the line for a couple. Freshman has had good lines when you look at the box scores, except the game at Notre Dame Thursday night when he was way off, 1 of 7 against the Irish, 3 points.
Well, he and Poitras combined to only score 6 points on 2 of 8 field goals in that game, Jim. Poitras was in some foul trouble, which impacted his production, but those are the two top scorers for this team. Off to better starts here today.
Heslip swatted away by Cauley Stein. 16 seconds on the shot clock.
Plenty of time to get a high-quality shot. I'd expect it to get into Pierre Jackson's hands after he inbounds it. And then perhaps some type of pick and roll.
May have had Austin there for a moment. Jefferson, give it back to Jackson.
Floor is spread, so let's see. Here comes the screen. And he rejects it, which he likes to do. Nice look.
To the corner. Got a good look. Put back.
No need to shoot that one.
No, it could have held it for the last shot.
No need to shoot that one. He wasn't in position or on balance, and they could have gotten the last shot, as you said, Jim.
And now Kentucky can go to the locker room, tying it with a two, a lead with a three. No, it's going back to Baylor. Baylor's got time. 2 seconds. They feed Heslip. Got the shot in time, and it goes. Wow, Brady Heslip. Jackson ran that just right. The floor general. He knew exactly how much time they had, and Heslip got the feet planted and the good shot.
You're exactly right. You're all over it there, Jim. Pierre Jackson doing what he loves to do, set up his teammates, And there are very few in the country that shoot the three better than Brady Heslip.
Kentucky led 17-9 with 10 minutes to go in the half. Baylor closes it 25-12 stretch. They're just going to double check here.
No reason to. Nah, he's on the in arena.
Yep.
Splash.
25-12. The last 10 minutes of that half.
Impressive work by the Bears. Got active in the zone and got some opportunities in transition and inside. Here's another transition opportunity. No brainer. Mark that one up, folks.
That's the end of the first half with the score Baylor 34, Kentucky 29. We'll send you to Tim Brando in Atlanta and AT&T at the half after these messages and a word from your local station. CBS Sports college basketball coverage is sponsored by AT&T. Rethink possible. Samsung Galaxy Note 2. The next big thing is here. And by Mercedes-Benz. Experience truly great engineering today at your authorized dealer. Kentucky is down five. Baylor will be inbounding here shortly. Kentucky shooting only 29% in that first half. Let's take a look at the Coke Zero first half numbers.
Well, you take a look at these numbers. I mean, Kentucky obviously really struggling to make shots. They got some quality looks, I thought. Neither team lighting it up from the three-point line, and the turnovers, a big story of that half.
Yeah, 11 turnovers by Kentucky, and the Wildcats missed their last five shots from the floor. Jefferson got the 101 over Wiltshire, and he's able to convert. He now leads the Bears with 10 points.
Nice move that time, Jim. Took his time and shot the nice little turnaround jumper. I love that look.
Wiltshire, that hit him in the face. He was able to recover.
Well, nobody's really attacking here, Jim. They're just kind of passing it around. You've got to probe into the seams against the zone, and they need him to knock one of these down. Another good look for Wiltshire that doesn't go.
Comes back out to Baylor. Bears trying to end Kentucky's 55-game home win streak, and that's thrown away by Jackson.
Nice work here by Jefferson. Takes his time, feels his defender in a nice little shimmy shake. Fake to the baseline and then went to the middle. Well executed.
Noel. Follow up, no. Had two Wildcats in there and only Jefferson for Baylor, and he's able to come away with it. And they're going to call a foul here on Nerlens Noel, and no one in this arena is happy about that.
I wouldn't be happy with it either. Taking a look at a good opportunity here for Noel. Good follow. And now we've got the tangle up. I think you just played. Oh, that's a tie. That's a clean tie up there. Should have been a hell ball.
Instead, it's his third.
Yep, that's a tough call. I think that should have been a hell ball.
Walton, what a move. Got past Poitras. Jim, and he has eight.
Jim, in the first half, you talked about how John Calipari wanted to see the competitive spirit of his team. He's going to find out about it now again, because it's when the winds of adversity blow that you find out how tough-minded a group is, how much they're going to stay together, or will they kind of give in to the momentum the other team is applying. And this is kind of what happened in South Bend a little bit with Notre Dame, with Kentucky.
And that adversity right now is a 9-point deficit. Austin on the line, back to Kentucky.
And you know, the other thing that exacerbates that, as we look at Austin, the big fella made a nice effort to try to save that ball. The other part of the adversity is when good shots don't go in the basket. Kentucky has gotten really good shots most of the game. Great effort there by Austin. We've twice seen seven-footers go to the floor.
Yeah.
quite quickly and comfortably.
Cauley Stein did it in the first half for Kentucky. Poitras gets it to go. Alex Poitras. Quickly at the other end. It's Noel pulling it away. Mays surveys, finds Wiltshire.
I think Kentucky has to continue to probe inside, try to beat up that soft area of the zone.
There is Goodwin after a 5.5 minute stretch without a basket. They get two quick ones. And now the Rupp crowd is starting to rally behind their Wildcats. Jackson, Wiltshire clears for Kentucky.
Don't settle if you're Kentucky. Continue to probe, look inside, attack the rim and the paint.
Oh, thrown way over the head of Mays.
It really was the right play, but it was just poorly executed. Anytime you can drive baseline against the zone, you want to look opposite and diagonal. And that's exactly what Poitras did there. The pass was just a tad tall. A.J. Walton upset about coming out of the game. I think he may be sitting because he took a quick shot on the last possession.
Bello takes his place on the floor. Walton has 8 points. He's played well. Open. Isaiah Austin with a 3-point shot, 7-1, and can really put a beautiful rotation on that long-range shot.
36% he shoots from the 3-point line, and you're right, he's got a textbook stroke.
And Jackson off his fingertips.
The Graceye Grassel, Isaiah Austin, spraying that triple.
I don't think you could define it better than that. As Cauley Stein will come in for Noel.
I'll tell you what, I have to go way back to the sweet shooting Jim McDaniels.
Western Kentucky.
You got it. For a big guy to have the kind of stroke that we see possessed by Isaiah Austin.
That's going to be a foul on Jefferson. So free throws coming up out of the break. Second foul on Jefferson. Baylor is up by 8. Kentucky has not lost a game at home since March the 9th, 2009, against Georgia. Kentucky coached by Billy Gillespie. And Georgia won it behind Terrence Woodbury's 30 points. And since that loss, again in March of 09, Kentucky has won 55 consecutive games at home. By far the longest streak in the NCAA. And again, Coach Cal has never lost a home game at Kentucky.
Well, they've got 15 minutes and 56 seconds to change the tide here. This Baylor team, I've watched them a handful of times before being here courtside, and they've got the size and athleticism, the point guard and backcourt play to, I think, give Kansas a real challenge in the Big 12. Kansas has won that league regular season championship the last 8 years.
8 years in a row.
Which is an amazing feat for Bill Self, his staff, and his program.
By the way, that last foul was changed during the break over to Austin, his first. And Kentucky's going to maintain it even after the two misses. By Cauley Stein, Wiltshire's shot is blocked.
Kentucky has to continue to move the ball and get quality looks.
Numbers for Baylor, and Jackson gives Baylor its first double-digit lead. Number 55, trying to end that 55-game home win streak. Good one. Nice move.
Beautiful move. The key for Kentucky, Jim, Baylor has found a nice rhythm. Kentucky has to continue to probe that zone, attack it, and then be ready to knock down the good shots that become available. Defensively, they've got to stay disciplined and aggressive. That's sometimes a tough combination, but that's what they've got to do, and there's a good example of it right there.
Poitras gets credit for the block. Good one. Twice now. Back-to-back trips.
He is a terrific scorer, Jim. An absolutely gifted scorer.
Archie Goodwin. It's a strong reaction here at Rupp. Coming up after this one, CBS Sports College Championship Saturday. College football today. And the showdown for a perch in the national title game. Crimson Tide and the Bulldogs in the SEC title game coming up on CBS. Yes, A.J. McCarron and Aaron Murray ready to do battle. Look at those numbers. I love 25 touchdowns against only two picks. But 30 against seven ain't bad either, as they would say. Baylor leads it here 43-37, coming out of a Bears timeout. And Goodwin, Archie Goodwin, again by way of Little Rock, Arkansas, the 6'4 freshman, making a couple of beautiful moves to the basket. Back-to-back times down the floor. 13 points on the game. Tops for Kentucky. It looked like he might have carried it.
No, he kept his hand on top of it, Jim. You can dribble it as high as you want to, as long as you don't get underneath and then on top of the ball.
Jackson gets past. Good one, and it slides off the rim. Pauly Stein is there. Mays set up for the three. Outside, Jackson. Tightrope down the side. And it's a foul on Pauly Stein.
Jackson created that foul. He does that a couple of times a game where he runs into defenders to draw the foul. And here you see Goodwin. After Baylor had gone up 10, Archie Goodwin showing you that wonderful ability to get to the rim and creatively finish. The left hand on the initial one and then the up and under with the right hand, as you see Pauly Stein on the bench now with those four personal fouls.
Noel comes back in for him. Old give and go, and which way will this one go? It's against Jefferson, and that is his second as Noel comes in and draws the charge.
Nice job here by Nerlens Noel to leave his man and step outside of the restricted arc area and draw the foul. Well done, and that's awareness. You can't make that play as a defender if you're not aware of where the ball is and anticipating what the play is going to be. Nice job by Noel that time.
Good one. Can he hit it from the outside? No. Walton. Oh, that was a pass that did not need to be made. Trying to find Gathers. Good one. And it's staying with Kentucky. There was no call on the contact.
Archie Goodwin had a teammate he could have passed it to, or he could have used another dribble there to get around the defender. But that's part of the growing and maturation process for any young player, especially a player who's a natural two guard who is learning how to be a point guard.
And Noel. Good job of boxing out by Baylor. Four straight empty trips, though, for the Bears. Make it five.
It's going to be on Jefferson. Got caught that time doing a little hand fighting in his attempt to get to the offensive glass.
To the bench with three fouls. Isaiah Austin back in. So just when Kentucky needed to respond, the Wildcats have done that, even though they've missed a couple of opportunities to get it closer than six.
Exactly.
Wiltshire fires it. Walton Numbers aren't there. We'll go to the wing. Franklin on the floor for Baylor.
Two Kentucky players took themselves out of the play by going to the ground and coming up empty. So it was basically 5-on-3 there, and Baylor made them pay.
Timeout called by Kentucky. Jackson hits the big three.
Baylor back on top by 9. We're going to take a look at a good effort here by Kentucky. Penetration by Jackson. And then on this loose ball, we've got two Kentucky guys on the ground. And there you got Pierre Jackson wide open. Goodwin and Wilcher, in their effort to get to the loose ball, went to the ground. And that left Pierre Jackson wide open for that three.
Which ended a three-minute stretch without a Baylor point. So it's back up to 9 with 12 and a half to go.
Kentucky cannot become tentative against this zone, Jim. They've gotten good shots all game long, and there's another good look. They just haven't converted enough of them, and they've actually done a good job on the offensive glass.
Austin, and that was blocked by Noel. That call against Poitras. Can Coach Cal lead back the Wildcats? Down 9. CBS Sports College Basketball coverage is sponsored by the Buick Verano. Unexpected luxury in a car this size. Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry with 5 times the selection of ordinary jewelry stores. And by Bud Light, it is the sure sign of a good time. Here we go. Here's something for you, Clark Kellogg. Baylor has never won a non-conference road game against a top 25 ranked team. In program history, 0-18. So Scott Drew and his Baylor Bears not only could make history by shutting down the win streak at home for Kentucky, but could pull off something that no Baylor team has ever done. Win a non-conference game on the road against a ranked team. Now Kentucky coming into the week number 8, having lost Thursday night to Notre Dame. So will fall regardless of the outcome here.
Mm-hmm.
But it would be history for the Bears.
Sure would be, and they're up 9 because they're winning the points off turnovers battle by 13. They've made a couple of more threes, and they're plus 7 in fast break points. And Kentucky has only made 28% of what I think have been, for the most part, really good shot attempts.
Traveling call on Gathers, and before that break, that foul call was on Archie Goodwin. His first. Harrow is back on the floor, number 12 for Kentucky right here.
They've got Harrow out there now, which will free up Goodwin to slash, drive, and try to make plays for himself or teammates. And that's a great play by Nerlens Noel.
Basket counts. Foul is on Gathers.
Well, on the wing, Goodwin able to get just kind of a shoulder by his defender. And that's just an outstanding effort by Noel. The pass wasn't that good, but Noel made an exceptional play on it.
Gathers will go out with 4.
You look at this Kentucky team that's on the floor now. Mays is, in fact, a graduate student, but first year at Kentucky. Harrell, transfer, and then 3 freshmen. So you're looking for leadership and direction, maturity, and it's just not quite there. It will get better as the season goes on. But this is a real challenging point in this game for Kentucky. Can the home crowd help them? Can guys rise up and make plays in a mature and disciplined fashion? We'll find out.
Heslip just reinserted. It's over to Walton, back to Jackson.
And the flip side of the coin, the backcourt of Baylor, 2 seniors and a transfer junior.
What a shot, a 3 by Walton, right in front of his bench. And after Baylor missed its first seven from three to start this game, the Bears have made six of their last 11. Harrow. Noel. No call, and Jefferson clears it. That was a very important shot by A.J. Walton a moment ago.
Huge. And then the good defensive stand.
Walton, a senior, has it again. Jefferson short on the jumper. Pass was behind Mays, lost his momentum. Poitras dips down and out. Looked like it was halfway down.
And a pretty good look again, Jim.
Kentucky's missed its last seven threes.
And Jim, this is where you've got to have that fortitude and discipline to stay after it, even though you're missing good shots.
Just like that with the block by Poitras, igniting the fast break. Goodwin at the other end will shoot a pair. It's one thing to make a three, but then it's about timing, and then it's also you got your teammates right behind you on the bench.
Yeah, he was juiced after that one. That was a heck of a step back three, and then right on the heels of that three, good presence by Austin and Jefferson to deny Noel.
Fourth foul on Jefferson, so now two Bears saddled with four. Gathers and Jefferson. Good one. Planks the first one. Monday, Dave's All New with Led Zeppelin. Plus, later this week, pop sensation One Direction makes its late show debut. And, of course, always catch Craig Ferguson right behind Dave, only CBS. One of two for Goodwin. 8-point lead for Baylor.
See, this is where I think Baylor plays through its three experienced backcourt players. Tough pass by Austin.
Up ahead, Goodwin for the dunk. In front, gets the steal. And out with it comes Jackson. We were here last night when Baylor arrived after 8 o'clock for a brief shoot around, and the kids came out, took pictures with their phones, looked around. We got asked a lot, how loud does it get in here? Well, they're finding out right now. Timeout, Baylor.
Timeout called by Scott Drew there. His team had a 10-point lead, 9-point lead, starting to get away from what it needs to do to finish this off. They've got to play through the three guards. The last two possessions, Austin had a turnover out top, not strong enough with the ball, and then on a post feed attempt, Austin not strong enough yet to keep his defender from getting around him. I think the ball has to stay in the hands of Jackson, Walton, and Heslip for the most part to make a play and create a shot. And that's what they did right there.
Traveling call.
They tried to isolate Walton. It was a call play, but the official rightly called Walton for the walk as he picked up his pivot foot. But I like the decision by Drew there to try to isolate one of his experienced backcourt players.
He traveled in the 18th turnover against Baylor. Mays, oh, he hits the three. And it's down to three. Bears with three straight trips with a turnover. Coming unhinged here in the last couple of minutes. Jackson will calm things down with the jumper.
And he got fouled, Jim. He knew his defender was behind him. Got right into a solid jump stop, was expecting contact, and continued to concentrate on that mid-range jump shot. I talked about his savvy at the top. Once he beat Goodwin, he knew he was behind him, and then still got into a shot and drew the foul.
And Goodwin's second. Ends a three-minute stretch without a basket for Baylor. And you just saw a good reason why. Hit a three a short while ago while he hits this two and tries to make it a three-point play again. Why he is the Big 12 preseason player of the year. ...52-46 Baylor inside eight. Harrow with his best move of the game. The former NC State guard. With the three and the freshman off the front of the rim.
Same play they just ran, trying to free up Harrell.
Good one. Missing out on the opportunity to cut it to two. It's Gathers back on the floor with four fouls.
Boy, and Goodwin guilty of a foul that time on Pierre Jackson.
That's his third. So, Kentucky rallying, trying to defend its home court. And it's starting to get raucous at Rupp Arena. The lead had been 10. By Baylor, it's now four. Jim Nance, Clark Kellogg back here courtside, Rupp Arena in Lexington. Where are we going with this to the finish?
Well, you know what? It's been sloppy, but it's been entertaining and competitive. I think Baylor plays through its guards, and then obviously Kentucky has to stay on the attack and knock down the good shots they get. I think they've gotten, for the most part, quality shots. They've rushed some of them, but others they've just missed. They need somebody to be, and Goodwin's going to be a guy they go to an awful lot. And Harrow, I think, has found his legs a little bit operating against that zone defense of Baylor. So shot making and execution, it always comes down to that in a close one late, partner.
Goodwin leading all scorers with 16 points, just picked up his third foul. There he is. And Baylor to inbound. Underneath, Austin beats him on the inbounds play.
That's just inattention to detail.
And Coach
waves his hands
in frustration.
Yep. Part of having a young team, but still, you can't make those kind of mistakes late.
Lob by Harrell and converted by Poitras.
Like what I'm seeing from Harrell. Made two excellent plays here in the last couple of possessions for Kentucky. Very much within himself and confident.
Down the Gathers. And a reset with Jackson, 12 on the shot clock.
They rely on him to make a play for himself or his teammates here.
Gathers, offensive glass, and the basket drops, plus one.
Big time. Big time get and finish by Rico Gathers. Started by the penetration of Jackson. Draws defenders, shot blockers come over. Noel did a nice job to back off. And then a better job by Gathers to gather up the board and take his time and draw the foul on the putback.
So a Baylor freshman at the line to get it back to seven, and it rattles out.
Still just a two-possession game. Mays dangerous from the three-point line.
Harrow trying to make another play. Walton racing to the other end. Bring it back outside. Jackson frees himself for the three. And Kentucky has it down four.
Really having a lot of success is Kentucky with Harrell's penetration. Tough shot that time. But he's getting into the lane. He can make this. Good decision, though, not to pull the trigger early in the shot clock there.
As we go inside 5 minutes and a timeout, Baylor.
Penetration by Harrell. That means people have to help. Nobody gets a body on Noel. And he punches it down. It's tight going down the stretch here in Lexington.
55 consecutive home wins. Is 55 the limit? Can Kentucky come back from 10 down in the second half? Got the momentum going right now, but the ball belongs to Baylor at the 450 mark. Austin, 2-point shot.
Well done. That was all made possible by A.J. Walton's poise with the dribble. Never got flustered, even though he was under pressure, and created a good shot for a good shooter.
Goodwin steps in, and Jefferson defends it into the arms of teammate Austin and over to the floor general Jackson.
One of the things with young players that they have to grow through and out of is predetermining what they're going to do on offense instead of reading the situation. That looked like a predetermined pass by Goodwin.
That's another foul on Goodwin. He's picked up four here in the second half. And here is our AT&T Fast Analysis.
Well, we talked about Pierre Jackson at the top for Baylor. He's done a nice job. His presence has been felt. He's led his team in scoring to this point, has virtually gone the distance, has four steals and five assists plus 13 points on the... And Pierre Jackson going to be very much engaged in everything that Baylor does the rest of the way. As a matter of fact, he should control the ball for the bulk of every possession if they don't have something quick in the early offense.
He will be shooting a 1-1. Each team has a timeout remaining.
Goodwin picked up his fourth foul, which sends Pierre Jackson to the line.
Jackson, here in the early season, in the last 5 minutes, is 9 out of 10 at the line.
He's a competitive young man, has a great will to win, and has the ability to make winning plays late. So we talked to him yesterday, last night, when they showed up just to shoot around for a few minutes, and asked him, what did he think about Rupp Arena? He said, man, this place is big.
Yeah, it's big.
I said, wait till you see the blue and white in here tomorrow. But obviously, it hasn't fazed him. He's turned it over a bit, but his presence is always noticed and felt at both ends of the floor.
Now with 15 points, 10 in this half. The Baylor team trying to compare it a little bit to Allen Fieldhouse at Kansas. This Rupp Arena, where they're trying to break the home win streak.
Pierre Jackson almost got a steal there. Nice job that time to force Harrell out of the middle.
Noel back to the rim, second chance rejected.
Those are shots that Noel will have to be able to convert, and Pierre Jackson, as I said, will be in the middle of everything the rest of the way. But Noel has had a number of those close looks that he just hasn't been able to convert today.
Jackson takes the jumper. And the long board out to Noel. He's shutting off Harrell now on that penetration. Open, Poitras. Got it back and one. Well, he looked like on the baseline he didn't know what he wanted to do with it. Put up a shot that lacked confidence, but then he crashed the boards and created something.
You called it all there, Jim. Tentative, not quite shot ready, but then assertively pursuing the miss and finishing. And that's what everybody around the Kentucky program wants to see from him more consistently. And his assertive mindset. Because he certainly has the package in terms of basketball skills.
Long rebound out to Walt. Kentucky now 8 of 16 from the line.
Yep, they've hurt themselves there. Now it's a matter of milking the clock, getting a high-quality look every time. And late in the shot clock, you'll run pick and roll, most likely with Pierre Jackson. Goodwin has to be careful. He's got the 4 fouls.
6 on the shot clock. Walton takes it to the paint. And off the front of the rim with Noel there. 15 rebounds for Noel. Goodwin and traffic is fouled. So foul call on Walton. Be 2 shots for Archie Goodwin, who's had a little pattern in this game, missing the first and making a second. And he's been coming to the line. Monday to succeed in business, the girls will need a killer instinct, especially when they have uninvited guests. All new, 2 Broke Girls, Monday only, CBS. And again gets the second one. 5-point margin as we approach 2 minutes. Baylor looking for a first ever road win in school history against a ranked opponent out of conference.
Good active pressure here by Kentucky defensively. I think Jackson needs to keep it until he's ready to shoot it or give somebody else a shot.
And when he tried to split the defenders, and the call is going to be against Kentucky.
Goodwin. I think it's Goodwin.
I think it is Goodwin. If that is, that'll be number 5. And it is.
Yep, he got right through there, and there's the foul, clearly. No questioning that.
He didn't have any fouls in the first half. They've all come in the second half, so the man who has led Kentucky in scoring today is now out of this game with 17 points.
You know, that young man there, Archie Goodwin, being forced to transition to playing the point guard as they figure out whether Ryan Harrell can handle the responsibility. And as a result, this team will suffer as he continues to grow into understanding how to run a team. And when you're so young as a group, you don't have that mentor, that experience, that upperclassman to show you how and to move you through the tough stretches. And it might be just enough to cost Kentucky here today.
1-1. He's 3 of 3 at the line today. Now, you bring up a point that is really evident here. You take last year's team with all the decorated freshmen. They still had Darius Miller, though. They had a guy. They've always had a guy here since Coach Cal arrived.
That's right.
Who had the experience and the leadership to tell the young crew.
Right.
How it's done.
And don't discount the presence of Terrence Jones and Deron Lamb. They were starters as freshmen. They were sophomores. And at Kentucky, being a sophomore is like being a senior.
That's right.
Based on how things have gone the last few years. So that's invaluable and often undervalued and overlooked until you run into experienced teams that can exploit you.
Jackson now a huge 5 of 5 from the line. Mays, oh, that dipped down and out. And Baylor has it.
How many of those has Kentucky had, Jim? Well, outside and inside today.
Well, Mays just had that one. Poitras had a 3 earlier in this half that also looked like it was going to drop. Kentucky sitting at 55 points. And again, that 55 number is a big one so many different ways here today as Jackson bearing that number is called for a five-second violation. And that's something Kentucky needed to force with 1:14 to play. A three-possession game.
You don't have to settle for a three. You need to attack the rim if you're Kentucky. Don't stay passive. They're looking for Mays for a three. They've got to dribble this thing and try to get it inside. You don't have to get a three here.
Wilt Jer. Twice, no. Noel also missing a short one on the tab. Poitras fighting for it. He was
tied up.
Tied up indeed, and the arrow stays on Kentucky's side.
I think that's a big part of the summation of the day for Kentucky, Jim. I'm telling you, they have missed an awful lot of good shots. And I don't want to discredit Baylor at all. Baylor's come on the road and played pretty well, but 30% shooting for Kentucky. And the quality of the shots that they've taken, for the most part, has been good.
Harrell. And it's Jackson coming out with it. With 44 seconds. Again, splits the defenders in valuable seconds. Starting to tick away, and there's a foul on Poitras. And Heslip, who has not scored in this half, but hit that huge three going into the locker room, will be at the line.
You know, you talk about that shot he hit at the end of the first half. A.J. Walton splashed the three at a critical time. Isaiah Austin made a big shot at a time when Kentucky was threatening. Pierre Jackson made a big shot when Kentucky was threatening. There were very few of those big shots made by Kentucky today.
1-1. One more coming. Joe B. Hall is here. And congratulations to Coach Hall, who brought a championship here to Kentucky in 78. Hasn't seen a loss here again since 2009. Coach Hall went into the College Basketball Hall of Fame last week with another Kentucky legend, and Jim Host, who has been such a big contributor off the court in advancing the popularity of the sport. But 35 seconds to go. Wiltshire, he got a good look.
He's had plenty of them. They just have not gone today.
And it's Baylor coming out with it.
Had to do it. No reason to foul. This one's done.
How about Kentucky's missed 10 of its last 11 shots.
Yep.
And the 55 number, that win streak will come to an end with Kentucky right at 55 points. And the ball in the hands of number 55 for Baylor. The Bears will have a first ever program victory in a non-conference game on the road against a ranked opponent.
Major milestone.
0-18 all time until today.
Special victory for the Baylor Bears, and they came and earned it.
So, history made here today by Baylor. Beating Kentucky 64-55, the Bears pull it off at Rupp Arena.